Yep, Giants in a big lead are going to have to try and do it again. But all things reset, the slate is wiped clean. As we enter picks and bans, once again, Giants on the blue side. So far, no differences. It's the Camille band.
Well, Giants really have no reason to differ too much. They banned Camille, Jhin, Jace in the game that has now become a remake. Vitality with the LeBlanc ban first, although that is standard. I wonder whether this shows some sense of divergence that they're not going to pressure at that Varus Jhin trade that we've been seeing a lot. Mm-hmm. And you can see Giants have to react to that as well. It's Jace is the second ban rather than the Jhin because they don't want to ban Jhin if Varus is banned. This is Vitality.
There we go.
Trying to at least toy with Giants a little, changing up, but it is the same bans. There you go, Giants with the Jhin lockout, which means the last one will be Shen if Vitality are playing it as the same as the remake.
Slightly different order, but otherwise all the same, and that would mean the first pick Ashe for Giants. They have little reason to diverge, as you said. Vitality, the interesting questions come from them. What will they do this time around? Because they drafted a lot of losing lanes, and we saw them lose early on in that game, but it's actually a Malzahar ban.
By Vitality here, so obviously not wanting Giants. I mean, Giants can first pick Ashe again if they want. This actually is shutting out Vitality's strategy more than anything. Vitality is the one that's played twice, but with Rengar up, is that what Giants?
They do.
Haven't seen Memento play Rengar yet.
Seen Kha'Zix a couple of times, but yeah, okay. Well, when bugs happen, you take the Knife Cat.
Too soon. Too soon. Vitality get the opportunity to pick the Ashe here if they want it for Steelback, which would then put Giants on the decision of whether they would want to take something like an Ezreal, a Caitlyn, a Sivir.
It's a no-brainer for Vitality.
HQ has only showed us Varus, Ashe, Jhin, and one game of Misfortune. We'll see what it is he ends up going for. Sivir with the Rengar turns out
very deadly.
Good. So Vitality, will they look for Graves here? Will it be a support pick like a Karma or a Zyra coming out from AOD?
Yeah, not a lot of jungles banned away, but as you said, the Shen was up. And there it goes. So Kabo Shard will be on the tank this time around. They've got some protection on their side.
Flexish could look to rumble here. We have seen a game out of Flexish on that rumble. It was not exactly a successful game, but not many of Giants' games have been, but still a matchup that you can play.
Up until today.
That Ashe, of course, being locked in is straightforward. That's the other one that you can pick if you want the lane.
Take the Renekton. You know you're not going to get the Gnar matchup into it this time around. Flaxish will be happy on that. They've got a lot of early game power. Let's see what else they lock in on the side of Giants. Still no AD carry from this team.
So if they don't pick AD carry here for Giants, it's...
They could also take another type of carry.
They could. If they take a bot lane marksman, whatever word you want to use for it here. Otherwise, they're going to all get banned out.
All right, so they lock in the Caitlyn. This makes sense. This makes a lot of sense, in fact. It's a solid laner, right? It can kind of toe-to-toe with that Ashe.
Ashe can actually end up winning trades, depending on how the volley pans out. But certainly a lane that we've seen kind of throughout the last year or two depends heavily on the supports. If you pair something like a Nami with the Caitlyn, lane dominance, Lulu does a similar thing. You can dominate the laning phase.
Well, that Ashe is paired now with the Karma, so some speed boosts on Vitality side, some shields on Vitality side will make it hard for the Giants dual lane. This could already be a very different game.
So Vitality, will they look to ban supports here? Yeah, banning out Huslin's Nautilus already. Giants can look to ban junglers if they want to take away the Lee Sin, the Olaf that we have seen banned out a couple of times. Yep.
Joko, one of his favorites. Not going to get to play it this time around. Ball's back in Vitality's court.
Will it be the Cassiopeia ban coming out from Vitality? They banned it in both games so far. No, continuing on the support focus. I do like that.
But focusing AOD, on Hustlin.
Yeah, AOD on this Karma. I want to kind of watch how he goes throughout this game. It's only the fourth, I guess, fifth game we're seeing from him now.
Another one doesn't count. Doesn't matter. It's all new, all reset. There's another jungler band. That's the Kha'Zix now, so that won't be an option in this game. It's Rengar on Giant side. What is Joko going to pick up? Do they take this for this rotation?
I mean, if they pick Graves here and save their mid laner, I think that's probably the most straightforward thing they're going to get.
Or, we saw the Gragas before.
Yeah, and this is similar basis to game one, where you have the Ashara and now you have Gragas. It's not so bad with Ash and Karma, because you know that you can push out. Top lane is basically a Renekton lane, so good luck winning that early for Vitality, but Cabo already knows that going into this matchup.
Back over to Giants to see if they're going to pick up for their last two. They need a support, they need a mid. They've been focusing, hovering on this Nami.
And if Knight doesn't have access to his Orianna now, because it is banned for the rest of the day, this would normally be what he'd pick up here, I would imagine, alongside the Rengar. I don't know, would it be the Syndra?
Could be the Ahri again, but the Ryze is up too, and there it goes.
Ryze is up. Okay.
Are you surprised?
I shouldn't be. Since it has been banned out in both games before. Will it be the Taliyah? I keep saying it out of Nuke Duck. I do want to see it once or twice again with Split. Well, I like seeing Taliyah.
Definitely a fun champion, especially if you're a fan of all those visuals, but the Cassiopeia was left up and out, so we get that matchup once again, a classic one in the mid lane between Nuke Duck and Knight.
Again, Vitality going back to game one style now. Lots of...
They played a lot better in game one.
They did. They had better fights in game one, at least around some of the objectives. But there was that once or twice that Nuke Duck got caught out. Steelback getting caught in fights. Flashing in a straight line, getting hit by Jhin.
See if it pans out differently for them this time. Vitality, one game down. We're looking to be closed out in that last game. And they get themselves a second chance here and a different composition to go toe-to-toe with Giants Gaming. Let's see if they can come out ahead this time around. It looks like there's a lot of power on both sides, some scaling. I mean, last game we went real late. Let's see if we get it again.
Vitality is going to be feeling a lot more confident coming out of this draft. I actually prefer this to their game two draft. Giants a little bit later on the bottom half of the map, but you've got Caitlyn, Nami, for some sense of lane dominance. Ryze, of course, can control one side lane while Renekton controls the other, so this might be a lot closer a game. It's gonna depend on that jungle path thing early. You saw Deficio breaking down that information level one. We'll have to keep our eyes on that.
Joko will definitely be keeping his eyes out for Memento, though. That was a rough one before the remake all happened. Memento on this Rengar is gonna try to make some big plays happen as well, but we might be waiting until 6 for it. We'll see what happens. Giants on the edge, looking to knock out Vitality and claim a big victory here in this all-important week to avoid relegation. Vitality trying to stay alive for the second time we get into game now. Giants, Vitality, who takes it? Let's find out.
As we get onto the Rift, Giants, can they repeat game two again?
That's always a tall order. Giants, they definitely looked like the better team. Game one, there was a lot of back and forth. They got the snowball, and then they got shut out, only to turn it right back around again. Game two, they were on par for an avalanche. But Vitality, they've got a chance here. Let's see if they take it.
Vitality, they know their bot lane in trades might get a little battered and bruised by this Caitlyn and the Nami. You can see AOD.
Yeah, elected for the coin start.
Elected for coin. Now, one of those things is that obviously you get a lot of passive gold coming from it. Allows you to move very quickly as well, ward come back and all that kind of thing. Wonder whether it'll actually build fully into the Talisman.
Yeah, have to keep track of it throughout the game. I mean, they've already got a Karma speed boost from Inspire. They can get an extra one on top of it. And this is a team that... their team fights are definitely not going to be too shabby. Once we get into later stages of the game, that Cassiopeia carries a lot of power. The Shen can be delivered into the fights. And, you know, we've seen what this jungle Gragas once again can do. For Giant's side, they have a lot of damage as well. Starting out with those Raptors, Kabo Shard helping out Joko. It's jungle buddy system all the way around with Memento and Knight on the opposite side.
Rengar against the Raptors can clear him, but does end up dropping a little lower than somebody like a Gragas will off the first one. You can see that Memento's already got his level 2. Joko just gets it, now heading up to red. Will it be the same thing for Joko? Will he ward? There is already a ward in the river.
Will somebody ward? The answer is definitely yes. HeQ and Hustlin will see as they trade down on the bottom side. They have wards spotting each other in their own brushes. Hustlin's been the one who's been taking the most poke, but HeQ has got a headshot loaded up. Looking for steal back with it as the trades continue. There it goes.
It's a very different lane now. Giants have themselves the sustain advantage in bot lane. You can see Memento has not gone aggressive through the jungle. Has, in fact, opted for his own Krugs.
Yeah, that doesn't always work, right? Joker's going to have a much safer blue buff take this time around, even though the ward's expired in the river. Much better game.
So he's going Krugs into recall and then heading up through his topside jungle, so much less aggressive. You can see Joko didn't actually place a ward in the river, but has dragged his camp further away. Trying to make sure he doesn't get caught out this time.
He's playing it safe. You learn, you really only make mistakes like that once, it seems. Back in the bottom lane, Hustlin is, he's taking pretty low, but the Nami sustain is not something you can really underestimate. But let's keep an eye on Memento here. He's on his wolf camp, but he was pinging, or somebody was pinging, rather, up towards Riverside. Don't think Kabushard's in a whole lot of danger this time around. Not only is he on Shen, but he's pushed in, so would not be surprised if Giant Select not for a dive.
Yeah, they were pinging around the Rift Scuttler outside the Baron Pit, so we'll see whether that's where Memento goes next. Nami hasn't exactly had the most successful return.
Two of those games were AOD. But yeah, Nami has definitely been one of the champions that has had a lot more trouble because it has been a pick when supports have just been banned out so heavily,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, that's very true. You've seen a lot of Nami into Jhin as well because the way that you can push the Jhin out of his ultimate. So it's not necessarily a comment so much on Nami's success as to more of why we've seen Nami picked more often. Joko's slower on the recall here, so with Giants coming top lane, Momentus is going to walk right in. Cabo solo!
He gets the taunt, and that's first blood. Flax is just tanking tower shots. Memento, oh, he only had to show a couple of seconds of presence. That's a big pickup for Giants top laner to start things off.
Yeah, and Cabo had been trading so heavily with Flaxish by the looks of things that he was just low in lane. You can see how far ahead Flaxish was. Now you put a kill on top of that. It's a Renekton lane topside. I mean, Giants going to try and utilize Flaxish once again.
Yeah, that's teleport burn now. Kabushard still on level 4. If Flaxish gets 6, this is a chance for Giants to open up and make a big play. Maybe on the bottom side, if they can get a flank TP, we might see a party down there. But Memento, already focusing top side. AOD low on mana, still punishing Hustlin. EQ, not deterred here as he's able to go toe-to-toe with Steelback. This has been the even lane, of course. Mid lane's been very quiet, but that might change as well because you can see Memento hovering around.
And Giants just pushing forward in the lane, trying to get a trade on, trying to equalize some of the push pressure that's
Nuke
coming
forward.
Of Ashe and Karma. Nuketuk is forward.
He's got 5, too.
He's got Joko on the bottom side here, so it's fairly safe. Yeah. Memento did recall. Stealing away those Raptors.
Yeah. This time, it's time for Joko to get some revenge, get the Raptor steal off himself. Hustlin's actually moving up here. He's going to spot them on the ward. Gets the plant out. And Joko's going to have to spend his smite. Doesn't get all the Raptors. All but one, in fact.
Yeah, just slowing down the next respawn. Of course, Raptors does have a long respawn cooldown. So it's difficult to continuously camp them like you used to in seasons gone by.
This is a nice change for Vitality, though. They're getting inside the jungle of Giants early on and placing some deep vision. They haven't spotted Memento, but they know now that he's arrived.
Yeah, here's the use of that coin. You built up a lot in lane. You can roam out a little bit, come back, and it's all right. Less reliant on that harass, but AOD is going to return back down.
Yeah, no trouble for them either.
Steelback's level 5 now. When he hits that level 6 mark, will we see them go aggressive?
So when we start to open things up, see how different this game can be. Vitality kind of got a new lease on life with it, and you know, when your back is against the wall, looks like they're playing it out very cautiously, but I guess that's kind of what you have to do. Kabushard already gave up that first blood, and he's going to have to give up a lot more farm if he doesn't want to lose any more kills. Cloud Dragon on the map this time around, so it's not a race for the Drake. Still, slim lead built up for Giants. I say slim, it's about 1,000.
It's a decent lead for now. Giants with their farm advantage topside, and we kill they got already. Joko's been spotted on his way in. There's a flash coming out.
Oh, and the heal. Wow. He just had to walk down there and they burned both the ADC summoners.
Yeah, all of that was because AOD in lane flashed and I would imagine put W down onto HeQ. Didn't want to get caught out by that root and get body slam flashed, but course, that was just off screen on the bottom side.
And he Q. And Hustle and Force a little under tower, so two summoners traded for one with the jungler's assistance. Joko's getting his counter jungle on, but the same's being done by Memento up towards topside. It looks like he might be focused in bullying, but wait, there's gonna be more as Joko's caught on a bubble, red buff assisting. Meanwhile, in mid, Knight gets grounded.
Level 6 topside for Memento. Memento's coming in.
He's in Viz, and Kabushard's gotta know something is up. The taunt's on, but the slice, Flaxish. Oh, the
nice
flash! And now it's Flaxish who's tanking too much damage. Dominus is on, otherwise he'd be a dead man. And Joko's looking to come down bottom, throws the barrel.
He's only level 5. He's only level 5 for now, but remember there's no summoners on Hikyu, so if he connects with a body slam flash, it might be enough, and that's why Hikyu and Hustlin are giving a lot of respect over on this bottom side to Vitality.
Nuke Duck was looking to make a play as well. Ends up being no kills traded, but Vitality, they get a lot of pressure on this bottom turret. Down below half health as Hustlin and Hikyu come back to finish the minion wave.
It was well played by Cabo in that 1v2. Recognized Rengar was coming. Obviously, then when Rengar's under tower, you know he's there.
Taunt away, flash juke. Yeah, that was nicely done.
So he also held the taunt until some of the initial damage had been blocked by the Twilight Shroud, then jumps out, flashes back under tower. Nice little play.
Yeah.
Get
gotta
to see those glimpses of Cabo where in splits gone by, we were rating him among the top laners.
Yeah, we talk about his carry potential, but it was also just general mechanical outplays. I mean, this is the guy that was doing all sorts of flashy stuff. We saw him play the Lucian top lane when it was in fashion to play Graves up top. He's like, okay, I've got a better AD carry than you do. But he also just generally did well on these champions. It's nice to see him capturing a little bit of that back, especially in a matchup that you're going to have a hard time with no matter what.
And then other people tried playing the Lucian.
Didn't work so well.
Hooney.
Not Hooney the tried a
hey,
lot of stuff.
He's doing great now, so.
Oh yeah, good for
nobody
him.
Nobody even is remembering those Lucian games.
I'm impressed that they got Hooney to play tanks, in all honesty. That's still taking me for a spin.
I mean, let's be honest. If SK Telecom come to any player and say, we want you to play for us, but you've only got to play like this. I think most players are just like, give me the pen. Where's the pen? Just let me sign the pen. Like, Season 4 World Champions. Yeah, let's go. Not Season 4. I was going to say
every other season.
Exactly,
yes.
I picked the wrong one.
It's okay. It's been a long series already, Stress. I think you can be forgiven. Meanwhile, Knight tanked an ultimate out of Nuke Duck, but as he got cleansed out after the fact, he was able to get away from harm. And now Memento finding a hard contest. Knight's a little bit low here. He's only got flash.
Coming in
comes Gragas, and Knight gets blown to bits by Joko.
Easy play on mid lane. This is the problem that we've seen up until this week for Knight. We've been saying he's been picked off a whole lot. Knight hasn't looked as really solid as we saw in Summer Split, and this is an unfortunate turn of events for him. Now he's on this rise that has been banned away from him, and now he's getting focused out by Vitality. Vitality are going to try and come down to the bottom lane. They do still have that explosive cask available. They didn't use it to kill Knight.
Choco, AOD, steal back all here, and now
they
Giants,
don't even
they
need
have
to
know.
Use anything.
There's a teleport flank, though. Hold on a minute, Giants, hold the phone! Out of the brushes is coming a Croc, but that's going to be a flash. Cabo Shard has the shield on. They can turn this one around. Joko is found by Memento. And he gives him some claws. Sunk in, no tower taken, but it's a kill for Giants, and now they've all arrived down bottom.
Vitality did not use the Ash Arrow, but used a lot of summoners to get themselves out. And actually, Giants hold the turret. If Giants can get somebody up to the top lane quickly, they can take that tower down and actually get tower first blood themselves. That's what they're doing on the map. You can see, look, Hikyu's going up there. There was a ping on the bottom tower from Vitality, trying to race for that tower first blood.
That's a good old swippy swap, and Vitality, they're still sending their duo down to the bottom. It's going to be a race now for this. Nuke Duck clearing away minions in the mid, but man, this is tense.
That Cloud Drake would have gone so well if one team had got it by now.
Ah, the most important Drake in the early game was actually the Cloud.
It's like watching, like, in a sports day, the egg and spoon race. He was trying to push up, carrying that.
Yeah, but this is the pressure now. Giants are looking to make it happen, but you can already see Vitality are closer to getting this tower down bottom,
Vitality.
And they only need a stiff breeze to knock it over.
Yeah, Vitality.
Can they do it?
They're going to get it. Vitality are going to get it on the bot side. Hikyu couldn't push up fast enough.
Oh, there it goes. Tower first blood. Vitality have the gold advantage despite being down kills. So they win the race.
Who even needs the Olympics? We got this. the foot race to first tower blood.
That's definitely an exciting event.
That was riveting.
Knight gets nailed by the arrow. In goes Nuke Duck. No, this is slow. The Realm Warp. Is he going to make it out? I don't think so. You can't trust in the portal every time. And Knight goes down again.
Yeah, Vitality. This is a much better early game. They are still slightly behind because of some of the advantages that were built up from that first blood from the top lane as well. But Vitality, you consider that the first run of game two, they were so far behind. What was it, 5,000 gold?
It was a massive disadvantage. This has been such a relief for this team to get back on their feet, to be 13 minutes into this game and honestly 500 gold behind. When you also get first tower blood, that's nothing. Joko's honestly not been set far back. He plays on this Gragas now, and he hasn't been invaded nearly as much. He's been matching pace with Memento.
Yeah.
And it's just great to try and build off of this. For Giant's side, they're trying to recapture it a little bit, but you're not going to be able to snowball this game nearly as effectively. They may want to play it for the late game. They've got a Ryze. They've got a Caitlyn. If this game goes 35 minutes plus, that's going to be a lot of power to contend with.
Memento and Knight are no ultimate right now. They were pinging on Nuke Duck in the bottom lane, but his tower does still stand behind him, so
yeah.
It's not an easy pickoff. And Vitality still a little under pressure here. You can see that Nuke Duck's having a lot better game than the last, well, than the first game. Nuke Duck did catch a couple of big shockwaves, but yeah. Hasn't been quite so successful. Actually, he's gonna aggro the dragon. Just checking.
Not something Vitality have focused on a lot. Just about every dragon in this entire series, remakes or not, have gone Giant's way. Let's see if that continues. There's a lot of deep wards here, though, for Vitality in the Giant's jungle. They placed them some time ago, especially that control ward down there, and it just hasn't been spotted by Giants. It's meant that they have more or less a good idea of when Giants are down on that side of the map, pinging in the mid, actually, and now they're clearing out vision around the dragon pit itself.
I want to see more of this Memento and Knight squad, where they're just going around, jumping people, getting the Rengar ultimate down.
Seems like they might have run out of steam, too. I mean,
yeah.
That's something you don't often consider. Like, when you're that far ahead and then the remake does happen, how much does that really get into the minds of the players that were on the up and up?
I mean, especially, you look at the lead Memento had, specifically. It was, I mean, he was basically arms crossed, like, this game's done, I set this up, everything. Everything is going our way. And then the remake happens.
Can't quite always rely on getting the big snowball. He did get a big kill for himself, and he made some plays up towards the top side, but the second time around, Kabushard said, that's not going to happen. And they were able to really stop it.
Oh,
here comes
Ashar
the Ash arrow. We didn't follow it quite in time. There was a flash away from Hustlin.
Yep. Looks like just managed to avoid it, but Memento has been farming up a storm in this game. 111 CS to 48.
That's true. Joko just hasn't been able to do the same. But what Vitality are able to get now is they forced Giants to push and defend against their tower push. They get themselves a dragon. Can they live? Here comes the Shen Shield. Wave is dodged by Nuke Duck. He just surfs around it. Now Hustlin might be caught. The bubble. Oh, Joko's going to go over. They're going to grab a kill off of this one. It goes the way of Steelback, his second of the game. And now Vitality are looking to push mid for good.
Hustlin couldn't get out in time. Flaxish couldn't get into the fight in time. And now Vitality are pushing onto this mid tower. A complete turn of fortunes, a twist of fate in this series. Oh, Flaxish!
He goes in. It's Cabo Shard. They take down Knight. It's Steelback on his third kill now. He's getting a whole lot of gold in his pocket, and they're going to get themselves a tower in the mid. Vitality, how much better can you get?
Vitality now have the lead on this game. They've been doing a lot better around objectives this game, rushing down that first tower. In the race, they've really focused Knight out. We've talked about before how Nuke Duck does well in his lane on his own, but now that they've brought Joko into the mid lane a couple of times, the rest of the team with him, Steelback has been firing off those arrows and catching people out. Giants are struggling with Knight on this rise.
They're having some trouble. Vitality seems to be finding all the pressure points that they can press on Giant's side, and they're even managing to get some oft-lost objectives. That dragon they took? That was the first they've gotten in six games, and that is honestly quite impressive in one way. Let's take a look at this play again, though.
That is impressive. But Knight was grounded, can't get off the Miasma, and Vitality take the kill, take the tower, and take the lead.
pressure advantage to them. They have Vision down on the bottom side. Nuke Duck is getting his split push on. Kabushard, he can just taunt away and stay alive here. Vitality, they have all the chances to keep on extending this out. Okay, that was pretty cool.
I don't think it was all that intended out of Memento, but he jumps back.
Blast cones are a really fun mechanic.
Until you misclick and kill the team.
Yeah. It's, I've tilted a few solo queue teammates for sure.
And me.
Yes. That was deliberate, though.
Yeah, I know, right? That's,
but Mento has some fun for himself. He just rides the bounce and gets himself the ward vision cleared up. Still, they haven't gotten every vision cleared away. Vitality have eyes on a lot of sides of the map. But you can see the Giants are not lacking for it either. They have quite a lot in the top side of Vitality's jungle. 2 minutes until Baron Nashor is going to hit the rift. And, you know, in game one, it was a big thing for Giants. It was a big thing for Vitality, too. That was how they started to turn their game around. Wouldn't expect it to be any different here.
Yeah, and Giants, you can see from the control ward's bot side, they're trying to eliminate the chances of Joko sneaking around into that mid lane whenever they're on the defensive standpoint, trying to catch any kind of pathways that Vitality will use to get behind either mid or bot tower.
Memento wants to go hunting, looking for a new pair of snakeskin boots, it looks like. See if they can bait him away. Nuke Duck is spotted. Memento has not moved. He's backing away.
Yeah, he's just hanging around. Didn't really feel confident. They didn't have full vision on where everybody was. We can see Joko and AOD now. As his two-man squad. Joko didn't have flash.
There's the wave. Joko's still on. Here's the Realm Warp. Ash Arrow is not going to connect, but it won't matter. Hustlin is isolated from the team. Knight's around the wall trying to answer back, but it's not enough. Even with Gromp's help, Vitality are still able to clean up Giants there. And now Nuke Duck's pushing top.
Hustlin didn't read the play in time. Knight was like, come on, take the portal out. It's over the wall. You can get it, right? And Hustlin's like, oh, I'm late. late to the portal.
Should've hustled a little harder. Unfortunately, Vitality, they're going to grab themselves that last outer. They're looking great right now on this map. It's 20 minutes in, and they're building the advantages up. It's 2,500 for them.
Yeah, they have a real good advantage for themselves. The only thing for Giants that truly is going their way is Flaxish over in that side lane has pushed out Cabo, but Cabo is getting to a point where he doesn't really have to worry too much as we are about to cross that 20-minute mark. Vitality awaiting.
We've seen such a marked shift in how these teams have chosen to make plays.
Yeah.
Giants have been gun-shy this game.
I think the problem is you can't excuse Giants' mentality of, okay, well, I guess we did it in the remade game. Like, we can punish them, but the opportunities haven't necessarily presented themselves in this game. You can't really take away how much of a lead Giants had and how that's got to play into mentality to now have to go back into the game that you thought you'd already won. You thought this series was done, the seal was on it, you had your 2-0, you're moving on. And now you've got to play in another game with a different draft, with a different play style. It's got to be tough for Giants.
Yep. Despair, thy name is Orianna. Giants are still going to be able to grab themselves a turret, but they've got to contend with that snake up in the top lane. Knight's moving there, hustling himself to get in position. Still, Vitality making moves around the map, focusing on those objectives. We'll see how big a lead they can build for themselves. Last time, Giants were able to punish a couple of overextensions, and Vitality just weren't able to fight nearly as well as they thought.
I think, if anything, we're kind of learning from at least this game in comparison to the last two, is that Giants with a slower scaling mid laner just don't look like the same team at all. They look exploitable by a team like Vitality, who can move into the mid lane. They catch Hustlin.
Speaking of moving right into the mid, it was pretty easy. Kabushard just came a little bit late to wave goodbye, and you know, there's a Cloud Drake now 10 seconds away. Vitality could easily sweep that one up.
Oh, Cabo.
It's hard for Giants to really get involved. Hustlin has had a rough game himself.
Yeah, has not been the most straightforward game for Hustlin. I mean, when you look at what Hustlin's been playing, obviously in the last game, played the Karma, this time the Nami. Game one, the Nautilus. That's where he looked really solid. On that signature Nautilus pick, maybe we can see him go back to that.
Well, and even if they lose this game, obviously Giants, they'd still have a third one to play out. There's still time for them to reset. But even with the disappointment, you have to honestly shake that off and come back into it. That's what separates good teams from bad teams in a lot of ways. And Giants right now, they're not exhibiting the willingness to fight that we saw out of them in both of the games we saw so far. Obviously, you're down a little bit of gold, but how much does the draft really dictate that stress?
I think the draft in this one's dictated quite a lot, specifically with Knight and how he's now playing a slower-paced champion than Inari. I think it's difficult to kind of look at things and say, hey, you got to shake it off. Like, it happens. It happens, right? Like, I think at this level, we see teams with differing support staffs, right? Where we know teams like G2 have been very vocal about having, you know, wellness coaches and that side of things. And we haven't heard Giants talk so much about that. We've not seen a glimpse into that side of the support staff. So I actually would be interested to know how shaking off that feeling actually goes when you were so crushingly far ahead.
Yeah, that's a good point you bring up. And Giants as an organization have not been, in all honesty, the most vocal about any of their plans. Mm. It's a team that has been in the LCS for a long time, but you know, they've had a history of kind of almost alternating results. We talked about it, that they kind of come in and they end up, you know, right on the edge of promotion tournament, if not just outside of it, and then they end up making playoffs, usually to one and done status.
Yeah.
But they've shifted their teams and their rosters quite a lot. And this is a team that is still trying to find an identity a couple years on in the LCS. Memento is going to throw the Bola strike out onto Steelback, but Joker was there for the defense. They've caught him in a Bola and a Rune Prison, but Nuke Duck now is around the side. This is a hectic fight here. Knight's going to have to burn a couple of summoners. The wave comes in. Cabo Shard around from the flank, and now the TP's coming in for that Crocodile. What can Flaxish do? Nothing. He's exhausted. Turns back onto Nuke Duck. This is a fight on multiple fronts. AOD hustling both low, but Nuke Duck gets Flaxish, and now Knight's on the portal. It's gone canceled, and he's got nowhere to go. Vitality get two.
They have got this lead already, and Giants were stretching to try and get mid-tower. You saw Memento pop the ultimate, trying to just put the fear in Vitality, but it didn't work. Vitality know that they had the lead. Vitality know that Giants right now are struggling. 0-4-0 for Knight. Nothing on the board for Hikyu on this Caitlyn. He's still too weak to fight, and that's the Baron going to Vitality. This is a complete turnaround from the last game.
Might be able to fight it once again.
Yeah.
Backed away, okay. Memento is still just sniffing that one out. But yeah, Vitality get themselves Baron on 5. Cabo stops his back. But it's only going to delay right now.
Yeah, it's only delaying. I mean, top lane was pushed out as well. That tower's already taken of the inner. So now Vitality are looking to just push through. They've got Shen with TP, Stand United. They got everything. Nuke Duck will clear out one side wave and come across. But look, Joko starts the fight. He looks way more comfortable on this Gragas than he did in the last game. Of course, this game he didn't die at level 2. But Giants trying anything they can. AOD trying to fight with Hustlin, everything. Heal going in the way of Vitality. Taunts Knight off the portal. And Vitality just turned for the Baron. And at this point, you have to look at it and say, okay, now Vitality are in the position where they've basically won this game. Like, they've got the Baron buff. They've got a split pusher. They should be able to take at least the inner towers and continue to force these fights. They've got Ashe, they've got Gragas, they've got all of these good tools.
The question now becomes, can they close it out? Can they keep themselves from, you know, honestly getting got by this Renekton, by this Rengar? They've got the Baron buff on. Where are they going to spend it? Cabo Shard up in the top side. Safest push for him. Oh, you got to dodge. You know there was a death trap being set up. There's a clutch ward, though, by AOD. Vitality stacking bottom side. So are Giants. Now they're going to try to move around to the mid and force them back. Let's see if Hikyu can hold here.
See, Hikyu set up a line of traps. The problem is, if that dive comes, somebody's coming around the back of that tower, and the traps won't stop that. For now, though, Giants are going to defend at the bot towers. Somebody has to address the fact that Cabo is pushing in a cannon wave. If Giants can actually engage here... Ooh, nope.
Spending two ultimates. Memento went through all the hunt. Hustlin sent the tidal wave out, but nobody's gone back for Cabo Shard here. Vitality are playing this at the pace they want. Memento is going to be able to get out of the Ashe Arrow, takes the Blast Cone Express, but
now
the tower's going down up top.
Yeah, they just go back to bot lane with the next wave of minions, give them the Baron buff, and push them into the tower. Giants committed two people to this fight, which means they're going to lose the inner tower. Shen will push the next wave up, and unless Giants respond in the bottom lane, Vitality are likely to push at least one of these inhibitor towers down. Now the traps come out. It's only 3 out of Hikyu.
Still a minute left on this Baron buff, and they're going to be able to knock down the inhibitor tower. They're still sieging on this bottom, even though Giants are staying strong. But it feels like damned if you do, damned if you don't here, Stress.
Full trap line out. This makes it very difficult for Vitality to push up. Ashe's range is barely to the bottom of those steps. So to actually step forward and attack that tower is near impossible for Vitality. You risk the engage coming from Giants onto a trap target. That's why Vitality have to move as soon as those traps are gone from mid. Now they move to the mid inner tower and push that one down. Everything's going Vitality's way. They want to go on Cabo.
Cabo's a little bit low here, but he's still pretty tanky. They knock down another turret. He buys time. He has flash, he has taunt available to him. Hustlin's taken low, in goes Memento, but there's no backup. He gets barreled and knocked away, and Steel back shoots an arrow right into the back of his head. That's gonna be an inhibitor tower now and a teleport in from Cabo Shard as he back to base. Vitality are looking to close this one out. Let's see if they can do it. Joko has got the Shen Shield. He went from teleport to stand united, and that's exactly what Vitality are doing here. Two members down, the wave's coming out, but it might be Giants that are waving goodbye to this game. A double kill for AOD, and Vitality are on the Giants base.
Yeah, Giants only have Hustlin, Memento still down. This is gonna be the game going over to Vitality. It's a significantly different remade game, and Vitality will even up the series.
1-1 will be the scoreboard. We'll be going to game number 3. Vitality, what a turnaround, and they will take victory.
It looked better for Vitality this game.
That's an understatement.
Saving grace for them. They get a different draft, they get a good setup with crowd control. And realistically, you got a feel for Giants. After how big of a lead they had, now they end up in a tied series, one game away. But Giants, this is where we were talking about regrouping. This is where they have to. It's do or die on this one now for both teams.
It all comes down to a single game now to decide who is going to be in a much safer position. It's a big week for both teams. We've talked about it endlessly, but with all the bottom four teams facing off against each other, this is where you start to build the momentum. Vitality have got a chance here, and Giants, they're gonna have to find some answers.
The sigh of relief after that one game out of Vitality has to be, you know,
sweat rolling down for sure. I mean,
immense
this is big.
Moment of relief for Vitality.
It's a big one.
Hard to state it in any other way. They look basically beaten by Giants already. So
yeah, and Vitality really closed that one out when they knew they had the lead. That's the important thing. So I'm really impressed that they were able to put it away once they knew they were in a good position to do so.
Yeah, and Vitality, you know, their early game worked out better. They got the engages throughout the mid game and just pushed Giants back into their base.
Yeah, that's the story. We're one game apiece here in this series between Giants and Vitality. We're going to send it over one more time to the analyst desk for a closer look at game 2.
Thank you very much, Pyra. Of course, this game, similar to the remade game before, it does start off on a positive note from Giants. And it seems like, DeFicio, you're right. It's not just small pathing advantages that Memento finds. It's also just consistent ganks in the early game.
Yeah, again, Memento, in my opinion, showing how good he is as a jungler, getting early advantage. The replay, obviously, it's just him going top lane, getting almost probably the easiest first blood of his life, walking in, killing Cabo Shard. And generally, like, watching him as a player is just really fun because, again, good pathing, he's not afraid to make plays, and when he gets an advantage, he's really good at using it. Sadly for him in this game here, the rest of Giants weren't able to kind of work with him to kind of snowball this advantage, and Vitality ended up getting, you know, small leads here and there that kind of snowballed into a bigger lead.
Yeah, we saw a lot more, I feel like, consistency and decision-making coming in from Vitality, a lot more coordination around the fights that they wanted to choose. Specifically, when we look at the mid lane, we did see that one instance of a fight, or that one instance of a dive, rather, where they knew that they had the damage, they knew that they could take down the opposition, and they just pulled the trigger.
I mean, they already got a kill in Hustlin here, set around the dragon, and then kind of instant engage on tonight. Really good setup from them, and at this point here, you know, when Giants is already falling behind, we can't really fault them for what happens next. It's a very tough situation to be in after that remake, when they were obviously doing so well in the game before. You start losing the new game, and then suddenly everything kind of cracks for you as a team. And so I don't want to sit here and blame them for kind of losing really hard in this game at all. I think just Vitality kind of realized they had the advantage. The Gragas didn't get punished early game. This is the first time Vitality didn't get destroyed in the early game, and they managed to get some more fights later on as well.
Yeah, outplaying in the macro decision-making when they weren't at that massive deficit. Now, coming into game 3, your Giants, it's the same question I asked you at the start of this remake. How do you stay focused? Because this just gets harder and harder with every game, it seems like.
Oh, yeah, it definitely gets harder and harder. Like, this is where a lot of it falls down to the coach, to the manager, to the players around, or to the guys around the players who is sitting backstage and can kind of be like, let's try and reset everyone. Just reset. Come on, we beat them game one. We did well as well in the next one. So, like, full reset, honestly, for them. Try and get that early game advantage in the draft and use it. You really set up Memento so he can be the big star who gets you ahead. And then I think Giants can still take the next game.
Okay, at the end of the day, who do you think has the edge here from what we've seen in the first two games now? Who's going to walk away with the series?
I think Giants is going to get a full reset, and I think Giants is going to go in and have a better early game. And then I think it's going to be one of those like really back and forth games, but I think Giants is going to grab it.
All right. Well, at the end of the day, maybe not the road we expected to come into a game three, but we will have a game three nonetheless. But that's going to be right after the break. It's going to be one more game to close this one out, see who will come out on top, Giants or Vitality. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Flash, in comes Gragas and Knight. Gets blown to bits by Joko. On to Nuke Duck. This is a fight on multiple fronts. AOD hustling both low, but Nuke Duck gets Flaxish. And now Knight's on the portal. It's gone canceled, and he's got nowhere to go.
1-1 will be the scoreboard. We'll be going to game number three. Vitality, what a turnaround, and they will take victory.